Now let's start the foundation. I'm gonna go to one of the elevations, create another level by typing LL. I'm gonna offset that one by 1.5 meters. This is gonna be our foundation. Yes. Okay. Make sure that you can see the new level in the sections. I need to move this up. Sorry, down. So my level shows there. I can also move this a little bit up. I need to check the other section as well. I need to move this down so I can see the foundation over there. Maybe I could also move everything a little bit away from here. Okay, let's go to the foundation level. I want to create some foundation by going to the structure tab. Isolated foundation. Okay, I want to load some foundations from the search of foundations folder. Maybe one of these. Okay, it would be very easy if we go with add grids. It's gonna put them in the grid. We need to take care of the visibility, so I'm gonna go to view range and I want to make sure that the bottom and the view depth are set to unlimited. Okay, I want to delete this one and this one in here because we have shear walls over there, so it's gonna be different. Also, I need to take care of the view range again. I need to check if I change this to level 1. And then I need to change the cut plane so I can see the columns above. Now, if you remember, the level 1 was offset by 1500. So that cut plane should be more than 1500, the offset here, so that we can see the columns. So if I change this to like 2000, it will show the columns. Okay. Now, I also want to create some supports here, so you see the columns are not exactly on the ground, they're like 8 inches above and then they have support over there. So now I want to put some columns here, so they're gonna transfer the weight of the column to the foundation. I can go with the architecture column here. I can also go with the structure column. So let's go to the structure tab, hit column, load family. I want to go to structure columns and concrete. How about I use this column, the square? Actually, it's not a square, it's 315 by 342. Okay, open. I'm gonna go to edit type, duplicate it. It's gonna be the same size as our wood columns, but it's in concrete. So 315 by 342. Okay, I guess it was 342 in here and 315 in here. Okay, yeah, that's about right. Actually, I want to put it at grids. Okay. All the way in here, finish. Okay, now let's go to a different view. I can also delete this one here and this one here, and on the other side I can delete these other two. Now if I go with select all the instances in the entire project, there should be 28 of them, which is correct. They need to go from the foundation to level 1. Base offset is 0, but top offset is 8 inches because of the wall section. That's okay. I also wanna hide this for 1 second. How about I select the columns here, I want to isolate element. Now I want to select only the wood columns and make sure the base offset here is 8 inches, so there is no conflict between the two. Okay. Now that we created the support for the columns, we need to create a support for the exterior walls as well. So if you go to one of the details here, it says the foundation wall should match with the CLT with the cross laminated timber plus cladding in thickness. So I'm gonna create one structure wall going from the foundation to level 1. The top offset should be 8 inches. That's how we see here. It says there's an 8 inches space in here. It's in here. Okay. So going from foundation to level 1 with a top offset of base offset of 0 and top offset of 8 inches. Oh, and I need to go to edit type, duplicate this. I want to name this as foundation wall. I want to go to edit, remove that layer, and change this to 200, and it should be concrete. That's all good. Okay. Maybe I would go with the finished face interior, and I want to start from here. Okay, I'm going to continue all the way to here. Here and here. Okay, so if I go to a different view, you can see them here. They should go from foundation to level 1. Now it's more like it. Now I also need to make sure that there is no conflict between this foundation wall and the walls themselves. So this, if this is offset by 8 inches, the base offset of this wall should be also 8 inches. Okay, and that's also true for this one. This wall base offset is 8 inches. This one also. And these two walls on this side. Also, I want to select these three windows and change the sill to 8 inches. If we do that, you see there is a little bit of conflict in here. Maybe I could go to edit type and change the 3000 to 2800 to avoid any conflict between the window and the beam. Now it's better. On the other side, I also need to select these three windows and change the sill height to 8 inches. Okay. Now it all seems better. Also, we need to consider a little bit of foundation just below the shear walls. So I'm gonna go to foundation level, and we have the shear wall over there and over there. Go. So if it's about 170 in here, I can go with a 350. So I wanna do this. I wanna create a structure wall. I wanna go to edit type, duplicate this, and this is the foundation wall for shear wall. And I want to change this to 350. Okay, and I want to go with finish face interior. That should be good. I'll go from there to there. Okay, how about I change this to 2500, so there is a little bit more space on two sides. Okay, I want this wall to go from foundation to level one. The top offset is 8 inches, that's good. Okay, and I need to select this for shear walls, and also to the shear walls I need to assign a base offset of 8 inches. Okay, and I can copy this wall to here. I can create a detail line in here, so it will allow me to mirror this line in here. Okay. When you create the stairs and everything, you need to also create some supporting walls for them. Now I can change the view range of the foundation level. I can change this to back to 1200, so I can only see what's going on in here. Okay, it's good. I have some walls over there, foundation over there. Okay, let's go to the 3D view. I wanna first reset everything, and now I want to filter. I want to see the structure columns, the foundations, the walls. Okay, and isolate the element. How about I hide these elements? Okay, so we have the columns there, we have the foundation column over there. It seems good. We have the support for the shear walls. Now I also need to go to the searcher tab, use the search all foundation. I need to select that. Oh, okay, now, and I can click once. It's gonna create some foundation for those walls. I also need to do it for this wall, and this wall. Okay, now we can also check the sections, make sure everything is alright. So that's the foundation. We also need to create two more of these for this wall. And we did it for the other one.